departments on behalf of the academic staff of our mountain colleges and on behalf of Mrs. Das, who moved to the academic in our mountain colleges. Thank you.
providence guides our lives, and by your command we return to dust. Lord, those who die still live in your presence. Their lives change but do not end. We pray in hope for our founder, Claude Martin, and for all the dead known to you alone. In company with Christ, who died and now lives, may they rejoice in your kingdom, where all our tears are wiped away. Unite us together again in one family to sing your praise forever and ever. O merciful God, take pity on those souls who have no particular friends and intercessors to recommend them to you, who either through negligence of those who are alive or through length of time are forgotten by all. Spare them, O Lord, and remember your own when others forget to appeal to your mercy. Let not the souls you have created be parted from you, their Creator. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that the founder of this college, who built this place, may sleep here in peace until you awaken him to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May the souls of the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
70 years. This service with changes according to the times has taken place in this chapel to commemorate our founder. There were very few things that he asked for, but he did say, he did ask for this service of commemoration of memorial to be held on the day of his death, which is not seen as a solemn and mournful day, but more one of liberation and commemoration. He also asked that a silent toast be raised in his memory at a feast that was to be given to the boys of his school. In both these traditions, Lamartine College has remained faithful to the will of the Father. And for 170 years, generations of boys have gravitated to this chapel. Every year, there will be new faces. Every year, there will be new faces looking older. For from the different batches who are surviving in different parts of the world, people try to organize their calendars in such a way that they will be here on Founders Day. With the advance of technology, we are even more fortunate that hundreds of people in different parts of the world are watching this program and participating in this commemorative service, because our media team is beaming this live through the media that we have available to us today. It's a wonderful feeling to know that people in different parts of the world, in different time zones, are up and watching this program, because it makes them feel connected with the school where they spent so many happy days. I am grateful to all of you for being over here. This is a service of prayer, and in order that we prepare ourselves for the blessings that we are to receive, let us first together recite a general confession. O God our Father, we have sinned against thee in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved thee with all our hearts. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. Have mercy upon us, we beseech thee. Cleanse us from our sins, and help us to overcome our faults, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. A prayer of thanksgiving. God of all blessings, source of all life, and giver of all grace, we thank thee for the gift of life, for the bread that sustains life, for the food of this earth that nurtures life, for the love of family and friends without which there would be no life. We thank thee for the mystery of creation, for the beauty that the eye can see, for the joy that the ear may hear, for the unknown that we cannot behold, filling the universe with wonder, for the expanse of space that draws us beyond the definitions of ourselves. We thank thee for setting us in communities, for families who nurture our becoming, for friends who love us by choice, for companions at work who share our burdens and daily tasks, for strangers who welcome us into their midst, for children who lighten our moments with delight, for the unborn who offer us hope for the future. And please join me in saying, for these and all thy blessings, we pray thee, O God. A prayer of thanksgiving for our Father.
We give thanks to thee, O God, for the wisdom and charity which moved Claude Martin, our founder, to establish these colleges. For the manifold blessings thou hast vouchsafed to these colleges since that time, and for the devoted service of those who have taught and served, and who now teach and serve in them. For the happy comradeship and abiding friendships that have flourished here. For those who have gone forth from here into the world to serve thee, and for those who are now here, for all the memories of the past, which ennoble and enrich the present. And let us say together, for these and all thy blessings, we thank thee, O God. A prayer for founders. Bless, O Lord, this college, and use it in all things according to thy will. May thy presence be ever within its walls. May it stand always for all that is true, noble, and lovely, and of good report. Grant that we and others may so gain from its life, that many may bless thee for the day when it was founded, and that its work may be extended and continued for the generations yet to come. Please join me in saying, for these and all thy blessings, we thank thee, O God.
Thank you.
days.
reading from the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 24, verses 1 to 15. Let us now pray, famous friends, and our fathers that begat us. The Lord hath brought great glory by them through his great power from the beginning. Such as did bear rule in their kingdoms, and renowned for their power, giving counsel by their understanding and declaring prophecies. Leaders of the people by their counsels and by their knowledge of learning, meet for the people, wise and eloquent in their instructions, such as found out musical tunes and recited verses in writing. Rich men furnished with ability, living peaceably in their habitations. All these were honored in their generations and were the glory of their times. There be of them that have left a name behind them, that their praise, that their praises might be reported. And some there be which have no memorial, who are perished as though they have never been, and are become as though they have never been born, and their children after them. But these were merciful men whose righteousness had not been forgotten, with their seed shall continually remain a good inheritance, and the children are within the covenant. Their seed standeth fast, and the children for their seeds. Their seed shall remain forever, and their glory shall not be blotted out. Their bodies are buried in peace, but their name liveth forevermore. The people will tell of their wisdom, and the congregation will show forth their praise. Here ends the reading.
It is our privilege this morning to have in our presence Reverend Father Donald D'Souza, Chancellor and Spokesperson of the Catholic Diocese of Lucknow. I want the boys of Lucknow here to listen carefully to what Father Donald tells us, which comes from a wealth of experience from different parts of the world, dealing especially with young people and shouldering at the moment tremendous responsibility. We are indeed blessed to have him among us.
Respected Principal, Mr. Carlyle McFarland, respected members of the staff, dear support staff, dear visitors, dear friends, and above all my dear students. It is my pleasure and an honor to be here among you this morning to celebrate with you the Founders' Day of this great and historical institution. I thank your principal most sincerely for his gracious invitation to be here with you at this commemorative service. I also congratulate you on this day, and I whisper a prayer for God's choicest blessings on each one of you who is associated with this college, those at present and also in the past many, many years. Our Founders' Day, while it is a happy occasion, is also a reminder and an invitation to relive, as it were, the great values and principles on which he or she founded a particular institution. In your case, the great Claude Martin, who founded this noble and historical educational institution, the Lamas College. When I was going through the biographical details of this great man, Claude Martin, I had to ask myself, How should one individual personify in himself such a vast amount of talents, skills, abilities, and innate gifts which indeed this great man personified? For your founder, Major General Claude Martin, was not only an able soldier, but also an architect of repute, a surveyor, builder, educationist, a banker, and above all, we must admit, a great visionary, all built into one persona. This was Claude Martin, your great founder. Born in 1735, he came to India in 1752 at a young age of only 18. Lived in our country for over 48 years, especially in Lucknow, and died in 1800. Today your college, La Martinia College, stands as a beacon of high quality education in the city of Lucknow. Started in 1845, it has had a glorious history of over 170 years, having trained thousands of students, among whom many illustrious men, be it in the armed forces, or government, or administration, in cinema or theater, in business or arts, in medicine or science, in education or sport, and in many more. My dear students, Labore et Constantia was his motto, which is also the motto of your college. Constant work, work and constancy. Today, when you remember your founder on this Founder's Day, it is befitting that you return to his person, to his life and talents as a human being, to his life as a soldier, a farmer, a banker, an architect, builder, and also a diplomat of great caliber. Today is a call, my dear students, never to be satisfied and happy at mediocrity, but to strive at excellence by hard work and constant hard work. This is the great lesson your founder, Claude Martin, is teaching us today. May this be your solemn resolve today, as you celebrate the Founder's Day of your college, at this commemorative service in honor of Claude Martin. May God bless you all. May God bless this college. May God give eternal rest to Claude Martin, your founder. Thank you, and God bless you.
To strive for excellence and not to be satisfied with mediocrity. We take back that message which Reverend Donald D'Souza has just now shared with us. Founders Day will indeed be meaningful for the entire year. The choir will now sing Brother Shout Your Founders Anthem.
Thank you. Let us pray. A prayer for our college. O God, who has taught us that the way of progress is the way of fellowship and service, help us to realize our responsibilities as members of our college. May nothing we do or say tarnish its good name. May loyalty among its members mark our common life. May the love of all that is good and honest flourish and abound. And in all that we learn, help us to remember the things of truest worth are those which bring us close to Thee. Amen. Prayer for all Martinians. O Lord, our Father, we beseech Thee to shield with protection of Thine everlasting love all those who in the days past have studied in these colleges, and we humbly pray that, by Thy grace, they may ever so order their lives as to be worthy of their heritage in the fellowship of this foundation and in the wider brotherhood of all those who love and fear Thy name.
Please join in singing the hymn, Lordiness, Holy God, we praise Thy.
thy colleges in Lyon, Kolkata, and Lucknow, as fields that thou hast blessed, and whatsoever things are pure, true, lovely, and of good report, may in these colleges forever flourish and abound. Preserve in them an unblemished name, enlarge with it a wider usefulness, and exalt them in the love and reverence of all their members as instruments of thy glory. Amen.
Remember today past trustees and chairmen, principals and staff who have served the world and by their efforts created institutions of learning which are famous the world over. We thank you, Lord, for thy grace and blessing to the founder and to all who have helped carry out this vision. Amen.
The choir of the Amantia Girls College will now sing for the faithful God.
Thank you.
choir of Lamartine College will now sing "Let Freedom Ring."
Thank you.
Let us join together and recite the public prayer. O Almighty God and most merciful Father, who has taught us to praise thee as well for the dead as the living, we thank thee for Claude Martina Sangha and for the life and examples of all who have served thee in this school. Pour down thy blessings, we pray thee, upon those who are now here. Prosper our labors as thou and thy wisdom. Cease to be best for us. Protect us, we beseech thee, from all things hurtful, both of soul and body. Preserve us by thy Holy Spirit from sin and selfishness. Make us generous and brave, pure and true, in all our work and in all our play. Let our task be sanctified by thy love. Our days here may be attended by thy blessings, and that when our day's work on earth is over, thou mayest send us rest from our labors under the shadow of thy wings. Amen. Shall we all stand to sing the following song? Followed by the choir singing the verses.